The Cambodian Prime Minister, Hun Sen, has been ruling for almost 3 decades. He came under international spotlight when he arrested the leader of the opposition for espionage. He has been criticized for being autocratic and corrupt, especially since China decided to pump in billions into the Cambodian economy as a part of its Belt and Road initiative. Who is this man and what is the story of Cambodia? It was the 19th century. Cambodia had fought numerous wars with its rivals Vietnam and Thailand, and the continued fighting had taken its toll, forcing King Norodom to seek protection from the French. France agreed to extend its support, and the kingdom became an autonomous region under the French protectorate. The colonial rule lasted 90 years until 1953, when King Sihanouk established power following an intense freedom struggle. He named himself the chief of state, and the next 15 years came to be known as the Sihanouk era. Across the border, the Vietnamese revolutionary Ho Chi Minh and France had divided Vietnam amongst themselves. With Soviet and Chinese support, the revolutionaries pushed the French out and established themselves in the north, while the United States backed an anti-communist regime that established power in the south. Sihanouk broke off relations with the United States and allowed North Vietnamese guerrillas to set up bases in Cambodia. The guerrilla warriors called the Viet Cong continued their struggle in the south, receiving support through a network of routes originating in the dense forests of Cambodia. The US feared losing Indochina to the communists and stepped up its assault, bombing rebel hideouts along the route. Sihanouk's rule ended in 1970 after a military coup led by Prime Minister Lon Nol, a leader favorable to the US. Many Cambodian locals despised the foreign attack and extended their sympathies towards the rebels. They called themselves the Khmer Rouge and were led by Solot Sar. With the support of the dethroned King Sihanouk, they waged war on the government. On New Year's Day 1975, the communist Khmer Rouge launched its final offensive, leading to the collapse of the republic. Sar adopted the name Pol Pot and became the leader of Cambodia. In his quest for social equality, Pot made some immediate changes. He ordered all citizens to forgo their property and move to the villages. Everyone was forced to be farmers. Religion was banned and people practicing Buddhism were executed. Intellectuals were targeted, including anyone who wore glasses. Family life was outlawed and children separated from their parents. When a famine hit, those who foraged food were executed, while others for just being too lazy. It is estimated that around 21% of the population was killed during this time. Luckily, the horror didn't last long. To stop Pol Pot, the Vietnamese army invaded Cambodia in 1979. The Khmer Rouge was overthrown and the People's Republic of Kampuchea was established, with Heng Samrin as the head of state. However, Pol Pot wasn't going down so easily. He retreated into the jungles near the Thai border and formed resistance groups. The bloody civil war that ensued displaced 600,000 Cambodians and left several thousand dead. It was in 1992 that a peace settlement was finally reached. The UN enforced a ceasefire to prepare the country for free and fair elections. Khmer Rouge tried its best to sabotage the elections. However, there was a 90% voter turnout. Prince Ranarid, the son of King Sihanouk, won the popular vote and entered into a coalition with Hun Sen, a former commander in the Khmer Rouge who had later defected and sided with the Vietnamese government. The two shared power from 1993 to 1998. During this time, thousands of guerrilla warriors surrendered in government amnesty. Pol Pot was sentenced to life imprisonment, but the peace didn't last long. Tensions grew between the two leaders, and in 1997, Hun Sen mounted a coup that overthrew Ranarid, after which he became the country's sole prime minister. He has successfully held power since, with accusations of him rigging elections and not sharing power adequately with the opposition. In 2017, the Supreme Court dissolved the country's only significant opposition party on charges of treason. But Hun Sen denies any undemocratic move. He has promised to boost the economy with China's help, investing heavily in the country. From a dark phase in the past, Cambodian citizens hope for a better future, but not without trouble looming in the shadows.